On today's Two on Your Side Town Hall, so many of you have asked, will we need a booster for the vaccines and will it become a yearly shot? We will have a guest joining us live to analyze what the CEO of Pfizer had to say about all of that.
Plus, a look at why hospitalizations keep rising here in Western New York. There we go. While the rest of the state really right now is going kind of in the opposite direction.
And then on a more positive note later, some expert insight into some good news, actually, about the economy.
Have to always focus on the good news as well, right, Kate?
Absolutely.
Good evening, everybody. There is a lot to discuss with COVID-19, the vaccines, whether you're going to need to get another dose, and also some more information about those breakthrough cases.
First, here in Western New York, we continue to see more people ending up in the hospital with this disease. So here is a look at the latest data that was released today. It shows that the number of people hospitalized with COVID-19 in the Western New York region increased to 331 people.
That's up 6 from the day before, and that total has increased, as you can see, 11 of the last 13 days. I want you to take a look at this tweet from a local registered nurse who said, 40 beds on my floor, over half are now COVID. This is crazy. Worst part is a lot of these people are super sick, requiring the maximum amount of oxygen you can safely get. This is just as bad as it was in December. I'm physically and mentally exhausted after this past shift. That is one nurse reflecting on what's going on. We welcome live right now Dr. Nancy Nielsen, who leads the planning team for vaccine distribution in our region. Dr. Nielsen is also a senior associate dean for health policy at UB's Medical School and kind enough to join us once again tonight. Several different topics. We're glad you're here to walk us through it.
Thanks. Good to be with you.
And Dr. Nielsen, we want to start with Governor Cuomo announcing today that New York State's hospitalizations have hit their lowest point since December 1st. But here in Western New York, we're in the midst of that third wave. You just heard what that nurse had to say. Why is this the only region in the state that's now seeing this third spike?
Well, there could be a few factors. It could be the variants, but the variants are everywhere. So I have to say this is probably behavior. And it's behavior by people who haven't yet been vaccinated. So that's a problem. That's a real problem because we just cannot tolerate letting people get sick and die when we know how to prevent this and we know what to do to protect one another.
Let's talk about something that made headlines today. And when I listened to it, I was a little bit surprised. Maybe some people will be. Mentioned this to you a moment ago, the CEO of Pfizer. This is what he said in remarks that were taped a couple of weeks ago, but played today for the first time. This is at an event with CVS Health. Listen to this.
I think that there will be a need based on this data for revaccinations. We need to see what will be the sequence and for how often we need to do that. That remains to be seen. A likely scenario is that there will be likely a need for a third dose somewhere between 6 and 12 months. And then from there, there will be an annual revaccination. But all of that needs to be confirmed. And again, the variants will play a key role.
So we'd like to get your thoughts on all that. Again, saying that revaccinations at some point will probably be necessary, maybe 6 to 9 months. I mean, there's still some, the data to be examined and figure this out. But what do you make of what the CEO said there?
Well, I think we expected it. Frankly, there's been a lot of discussion about this for a while, Michael, because people who've dealt with vaccines and viral vaccines in particular, and in particular the coronaviruses, we know that a lot of these respiratory viruses, you're going to need at least annual injections like we have with influenza. So it's actually no surprise. The other thing that may be, though, is not only would it be a booster, it might be a slightly different booster given the variants that are widespread. If you remember, the Pfizer and Moderna vaccines were developed, and it's this really cool technology, and that they were developed at a time when those variants were not widespread. So they're already studying tweaking, you know, the vaccine 2.0 to address those variants. So I suspect we probably will need some sort of perhaps annual, maybe a little longer than annual, sort of re-injection in order to keep everybody safe.
Throughout this past year, there's always something new to be learned as we go along, and the CDC put out data today on those so-called breakthrough cases. Those are people who are fully vaccinated, but then they still test positive. And there have apparently been about 5,800 so far. That's out of 76 million vaccinated people. So that's less than 0.1%. So what is the takeaway that you have from those numbers?
This is rare, but we have a lot to learn yet about who are the people where that might happen. Is there something that predicts it, and how can we prevent it? It is of concern. It is quite rare.
Dr. Nielsen, our viewers, some of whom may know, we've talked before here, we're both West Virginia natives, and there was a time early on in the vaccination effort when we were both quite happy with what was happening in our home state because West Virginia was leading the country in terms of getting these shots actually into arms. Now that is no longer the case. The numbers have kind of plummeted in West Virginia compared to the rest of the country. From what I'm hearing anecdotally with family and friends there, it's because there just isn't that high demand anymore. And they're not even at half of adults partially vaccinated. I just looked at the numbers. Only 42% of people in West Virginia have gotten at least one dose at this point. I wonder if that is indicative of the skepticism that is out there. And we seem to be seeing that here a little bit. I mean, it is pretty easy right now to get an appointment, and I wonder if you and other public health experts were hoping that demand would still be really strong at this point.
Well, we actually expected it would, because we still have plenty of people who are eligible, and we haven't had enough vaccine to meet all of that. But you're absolutely right, not only in our home state of West Virginia, Michael, but also here, we are absolutely seeing it, particularly this week, we've noticed it. It's like the demand has crested, and that's unfortunate. We really do need to help people think this through, deal with what their concerns are, and make sure they're making a really informed decision for themselves and the people they love. So we are seeing it. You're seeing the slots that went empty in every county in our region today, except for one, and they were doing second shots, so they didn't even offer any new spots. So we're seeing it as well. I think this is a phenomenon we're seeing across the country.
And on that same issue of hesitancy, is there worry among experts like yourself that a booster or then a yearly requirement is also going to lead to people not getting the vaccine, or maybe even questioning how pressing it is to even bother to get it now?
Well, it could, Kate. That's actually a very interesting question. But this is not like influenza. This is much more deadly than influenza, as we've learned. And the more we hear about people who are the, quote, long haulers, you know, the ones that have the symptoms that persist for months and months and months, this is a serious disease. This is not your seasonal flu or your common cold. So I'm really hoping that people will take it seriously. But to go back to where we started, the immunity to coronaviruses probably is not going to last like the immunity from other viral vaccines, like measles, mumps. Those are pretty much lifelong immunity. We're not going to see that with coronaviruses. So we need to expect it, and we need to make this part of how we take care of ourselves.
Finally, Dr. Nielsen, I want to ask you about one bit of misinformation in particular that we've seen out on social media and people sharing, that if you've had COVID, you obviously do have some antibodies, right? And, you know, that can help protect you, although we know cases of reinfection. There are some people who have said that if you've had the virus and you've recovered from it, that it's dangerous to get the vaccine. That is not true, but it means a lot more to hear you say that than to hear me say that. So can you address that? People who have had COVID, that they should get the shot?
Yes, let me be real clear. if you've had COVID, you need to get this vaccine, because you do have immunity, which will last for a while. But when you get a shot, it will actually by tenfold increase your antibody protection. So absolutely, if you've had the disease, go ahead and get the shot. You shouldn't have had symptoms for perhaps 2 weeks. But after that, feel free to get it, and we would encourage you to do so.
Such important information. Dr. Nancy Nielsen with the Vaccine Planning Team and UB's Medical School. We thank you again for coming back on the show.
Thank you.